This is a copyrighted work. Unauthorized copying or distribution is a crime punishable by up to 5 years in prison and a fine of $250,000.
Scholastic Audio presents Dragon Masters, Book 26, Cave of the Crystal Dragon, by Tracey West. Read by Emily Ellet. This book is for Graham Howells, the illustrator who created the look of this magical world and inspired the beautiful setting of this book with the tales of his homeland, Wales. T.W. I'd also like to thank Jennifer Keelan Chaffins for showing me how Llew would move through the world of the Dragon Masters. Before we start, while the Dragon Masters world is not the real world, many of the characters and places in it are inspired by real-world cultures. For this reason, I'll be pronouncing the names of these characters and places the way they'd be pronounced in the real world. These pronunciations may differ from how you think a name might sound based on its spelling alone. Chapter 1. Where is Griffith? A bright green light flashed inside Bracken Castle. Drake and his earth dragon Worm appeared in the training room. Dragon Masters Rori, Bo, and Anna ran to greet them.
"We rushed here as soon as we got your message," Drake said. "Griffith is missing?"
"Well, not missing exactly," Rori replied.
"Yes, it turns out there was an explanation," Anna explained.
Bo grabbed Drake's hand. "Come with us to Griffith's workshop." Puzzled, Drake followed his friends into the wizard's workshop. A young woman with black hair sat in Griffith's chair.
"Echo!" Drake cried. He ran and gave the dragon mage a hug. "What are you doing here?"
"I received a magical message from Griffith," she replied. "He had to leave in a hurry. He asked me to train with you while he is away."
"Where did he go?" Drake asked.
Echo's dark eyes flickered.
"He didn't say," she answered.
Anna frowned.
"When we last saw Griffith, it almost sounded like he was saying goodbye forever," she added.
"Drake, we sent for you before we knew Echo was on her way here," Bo said. "We thought something bad might have happened to him."
Echo stood up.
"I have no reason to believe Griffith is in danger. Come, we will have lunch in the Valley of Clouds."
Drake brought Worm to the dragon caves to rest. Then he traveled through the tunnel that led to the valley behind the castle. There, Echo, Rori, Anna, and Bo sat around a blanket topped with apples, cheese, and fresh loaves of bread. Drake sat down and reached for an apple.
"Drake, tell us about how you got rid of the sky shadow," Rori urged.
"Well, a lot has happened," Drake began.
He launched into the long story. Everyone listened without saying a word.
"And then the sky shadow dissolved," Drake finished.
"Whoa,"
Anna said, her eyes wide. Drake's stomach grumbled, and his friends laughed.
"I've been talking so much I forgot to eat," he said, and he took a bite of his apple.
"Drake,"
his dragonstone glowed as he heard Worm's voice in his head.
"What's wrong, Worm?" Drake asked.
"It is Griffith," Worm replied. "I know where he is, and he needs our help."
Chapter 2. A Rescue Mission.
"Worm says that Griffith is in trouble," Drake told his friends. "Worm, where is he?"
"In Greenshire,"
Worm replied.
"Greenshire? That's the village where Griffith was born," Drake remembered. "We need to go there right away."
Rory's, Bo's, and Anna's hands shot up at the same time.
"Echo, can I go?" they all chimed in.
"Griffith would not want us to leave the castle unguarded," Echo replied. "Only one of you can go with Drake."
She plucked 3 blades of grass from the ground. Then she held them out, hiding part of the stems in her hand.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.